Hi, crafters. This is Crafty Sabi, and I'm back today to share journal number 4 with you. This is number 4 of my carpet sample cover journals, and I love this one. Also, I love them all because of the blue. So again, there's some really beautiful blues in here, and that burnt orange and yellow. And those are just some of my favorite colors. So on this one, I chose to put a vintage button that goes very well with, it's very hard to see, but there's a paler blue in here, and it's actually this color. And so I chose to put an old button on there and use the sari silk ribbon to close it off. And then along the side here, I just have some really beautiful blingy trim and a piece of vintage lace. So very plain, and that's the back. And we'll just go inside. So this one has yellow on the inside. I love this one. It's very cheery and just makes me happy all the way around. So on the inside cover, first page, I have attached one of those. I think you guys saw this in, this is just some ephemera that I had. I believe this is a paper clip. It comes off. It just attaches onto here. So again, some ephemera. Inside the stamp envelope is some more ephemera that you could journal on. So that just was on my front page here. Just used a paper clip to clip it on like that. And then on the back side, I made a pocket out of some more of that Tim Holtz wallpaper. And there's a tag in there. And there's a little pocket there, some ephemera, some very old vintage ledger paper. And on there are some, it's a little glassine bag and some ephemera. That's a paper clip. Of course, there's like 1,000 paper clips here. I really should stop. I can't though. So here's another one of those itty bitty little paper clips that I made. So small, can't even focus. And literally I took a piece of fabric, I folded it around that paper clip, and I put a button on to match. So easy. And this flips open. You could put something, oh no, this one opens all the way up. So lots of room for journaling. And so here's another little take on those envelopes that we've been seeing with the journal pages inside. So essentially what I did was took my envelope and attached it to a page. And so I'll show you what's happening here. So this is the front of, this is an envelope. And so this is the front of it. So we'll start here first. So this is just a little bit of collaging that I did. It's a little Tim Holtz boy there, and he's just on some lace, and I tucked that into there. So when you open up this, it's attached to a piece of cardstock, so you can probably put photos or something on there. And then I used some of my Velcro little button, my Velcro dots on there. And so you open this up, and then inside are tons and tons of pages. I think there's 15 pages or something crazy like that in here. So it's virtually another journal within a journal, and I love that. So you can put more secretive things in there maybe if you'd like. But so yeah, that's how it looks. So this is all the journaling pages. When you close that up, The Velcro helps keep it all shut into a nice little package, and it closes in on itself like that. So this is, so you have to imagine, I wish I had kept one out for you. So it's just an envelope that I opened. I took it apart and opened both the flaps. So this one, and there would have been another one here, which is right here. So that's, well, there you go. So that's how I attached it. I attached one side to the back, and I used this side as a closure. And it closes like that. Had a lot of fun making those. So it's same basic idea what we've been doing all this time. You've been seeing a lot of sort of different takes. Tracy Fox and a whole bunch of others have been doing this kind of thing, but I don't know. Yeah, I don't know. I just like the way this looked. So again, if you guys have any questions, just let me know. I can explain it or show you how I did it, okay? And so then on this page is a doily, and there's just a teeny tiny little glassine bag in there with some ephemera. Loving these glassine bags, or these little stamp bags, just love them. Lots of room for journaling and writing. This is just a little pocket. I used some more of that wallpaper on there. And that's just a pocket and some ephemera. I goofed up here. So this was supposed to be a flip up, and I glued it down so I can't get anything in there. Annoyed. Anyways, it was one of those things. It was late, and it was like, as soon as it went down, I was like, oh no. Anyway, but anyways, so ta-da, it flips up. Big deal. I should put something on there. This page is a glassine bag. I just attached an old receipt to the front of it so that you could journal. And then inside is some ephemera. And that goes in there. And then on this side, I thought I ripped it already. Is a copy of some ephemera, and I coffee stained it. And there's another one of my little envelopes that I made on my punch board. There's extra paper in there for writing. That's Tim Holtz. And another itty bitty paper clip. Goes on there. That's my beautiful stamp that I love. And then this is just a little pocket. There's some ephemera in there. That's another little paper clip that I made. And just a little bit of collaging there. That's my other stamp. And then this is another glassine bag. And on the front, I just put some ephemera that I had and a little Tim Holtz paper doll there. And inside the pocket, I just have some ephemera. Let's see. Inside of there is just an envelope with some writing paper. And some ephemera. That's some vintage bank statements that I had. It just goes like that. This is some trim that I just recently got from my friend Dina. Thank you very much, Dina. Paper guacamole. And that's some coffee stained paper. Sorry, I feel like I'm gonna cough. Some ledger paper. This is also from a sari that I had. So some yellow fabric. I tried to keep the colors flowing throughout the journals. So this is just some yellow fabric. Love it. There's a little pull on there. This is just another little glassine stamp bag with some ephemera inside. There's some writing ephemera there. That's another paper clip. That's another flip out with a teeny tiny little clip on it. Ledger paper. This is a pocket that I made, and there's just another little baggie there. Some ephemera. And inside the pocket is just a whole bunch of papers and things to write on inside of there. Get in there. That. And that's the back. So that is journal number, what is it, 4? Yeah, I think it's number 4. And I hope you like that one. This one was fun to make. I love the blue and the yellow together. And that is it. So thank you so much, guys, for joining me once again. We got one more to go, and I will be back to show you that really, really soon. Okay, guys? Thank you so much for watching, and we'll talk to you real soon. Hope you're all doing well. Thanks. Bye.